War of the Roses, Chaucer's tales, the brutal feudal system, Holy Crusades, bubonic plague. Can't say that we've really missed them. So dark and barbaric, so dull and mundane. That was so Middle Ages. That was so Charlemagne. Welcome to the Renaissance, with all its painters and bonnets, and merry minstrels who stroll the streets of London, a strumming their lutes
in puffy bands and pointy leather boots.
Welcome to the Renaissance, where we ooh and ah you with ambiance. We're so progressive,
the latest and the greatest, we bring it to you.
With much ado, welcome to the Renaissance, where everything is new.
Here we've made advances in the sciences.
We have the latest gadgets and appliances. Our mugs are made of pewter.
Our houses are a Tudor.
Decorated with a modern flair.
See us in our petticoats and farthingales.
Our trendy beards are trimmed to look like swallowtails.
We're called Elizabethans.
We're all a bunch of heathens.
Heathens in a trifle, you know where.
While witches are burning and wars tend to start, we bring you moments of culture and art.
Culture and art.
Welcome to the Renaissance.
Our printing press has the fancy fonts. That's right, we're fancy and very literary, theatrical too. It's what we do. Welcome to the Renaissance, where everything is new.
Writing something new.
It's true, we do.
Like who? Like Decker.
Woo!
John Webster.
Woo!
Ben Jonson.
And Christopher Marlowe. Thomas Kidd, Thomas Middleton, Thomas More.
And our brightest star,
yup. He's the bomb, the soul of the age. The wiz of the Elizabethan stage. He's incredible.
Shakespeare is the top. Welcome to the Renaissance. where not everyone's getting what he wants. It's so frustrating, 'cause if your name is Shakespeare, you're hotter than hot. But if you're any other writer, then you're not. Oh, sorry.
Oh, noble kinsmen, that royal blood and love do bind, seek now thy own succor, flee thy native land. To die today, 'twill not be done till dawn. Teddy, ta-dum, daddy, da-dum. Who talks like this? Nigel, why can't we just write like we speak?
Yeah, I haven't understood a single word in the last three plays.
Nick, I have a question on motivation.
Yes.
Why haven't you given up yet?
Peter, this one's working. I can feel it. It's missing something right here. Nige, help me out.
Did I miss my cue?
Robin! What are you wearing? This isn't a dress rehearsal.
Oh, I thought it might help me get more to character if I wore dresses, hang out in the taverns, flirt with men, you know, for research.
So, Nigel,
Yeah, so I did write something in my notebook last night. Yeah. So I was thinking it might be good if King Richard were contemplating his own mortality. Although now that I say that out loud, that sounds really stupid.
Well, let me read it.
Why? It's probably terrible.
Let me see.
Well, it's probably bad, isn't it? I mean, I don't even know why you let me write with you anymore.
Nigel! It's good.
Yeah?
Really good.
Well, I did put a lot of layers into it, so...
One suggestion, though?
How about instead of tombstone, he says epitaphs?
Yeah, that's better. Good one, brother.
All right, let's try this, everyone. Let us talk of grave, of worms, of epitaph.
Yeah.
Make dust our paper, and with rainy eyes, write sorrow on the bosom of the earth. Yes! That is good. I'm starting to think this is going to be the Bottom Brothers' first hit.
Pacey, we have to shut it down.
Lord Clapham. What do you mean, shut it down?
Well, guess whose next production is going to be? The Tragedy of Richard II.
Shakespeare?
Oh, why is he doing Richard II? He just did Richard III. Who goes backwards?
Well, I mean, he breaks convention. That's what makes him so great.
Really? Did you see Romeo and Juliet? What's so great about two lovers that kill themselves in the end?
Oh, you spoiled it. I'm seeing it this evening.
You should. It's life-changing.
Is it? Love you, stab myself, drink poison, the end.
Oh, stop it, stop it, stop it! You're ruining everything! Now, I paid money for an original production, and you will lose my patronage, do you hear? No more money until I hear a new idea. On the morrow! I think that means tomorrow!
Oh, he quit! We're on a job!
Please, please don't. Don't, please.
Write something original. Like the bard!
The bard! Why is he the bard? He's just a bard. Like I'm a bard, you're a bard. He's just one of the bards.
He's the bard because he does it all. You know, histories, tragedies, comedies.
Comedies, yeah. Name one thing of his that's funny. Give me a line, anything.
On my word, we'll not carry coals. For then, we should be colliers!
That is not funny! Oh, God, I I hate Shakespeare. That's right, I said it.
No!
I do, I hate Shakespeare.
Why?
Just don't get it how a mediocre actor from a measly little town is suddenly the brightest jewel in England's royal crown. Oh God, I hate Shakespeare. His plays are wordy, but oh no, the great Shakespeare. That little turd, he has no sense about the audience. He makes them feel so dumb. The bastard doesn't care that my poor ass is getting numb.
How can you say that? How can you say that?
It's easy, I can say it, cause it's absolutely true.
Don't be a penis, the man is a genius.
His genius is fooling all of you.
But he's brilliant, what majesty flows from his pen. His poetry soars like a sweet violin. God's own inspiration, like lightning, doth strike him. And he captures my soul.
Jeez, you sound just like him.
Really? Thanks.
You should hate Shakespeare.
Well, I don't. I try to emulate Shakespeare.
Well, there's your problem. You're so blinded by the bar of a pompous little man.
Why is it a problem to admit that I'm a fan?
Because he's a hack with a knack for stealing anything he can.
How can you say that? How can you say that the man really knows how to write a bitchin' play? You wish you could pen one, we wish we were in one.
I just wish that you would go away.
Well, that's not gonna happen, because everyone I know says he's the greatest writer England's ever seen.
Dude, that's another thing I hate about Shakespeare, is all the twits who bloviate about Shakespeare, and how they prattle on about his great accomplishments, well, la-di-da-di-da, and once they start a gushing, there's no stopping them, and then it's blah-blah-blah-blah-blah Shakespeare, and she walks in, it's dum-da-dum, ta-da, Shakespeare. They're holding court, and they say, well, you're such a genius, and your writing is divine. A rose by any other name was such a clever line. And they're all, ooh, and he's all stuck, and they're all, yay, and I'm all, bleh, and we're getting a cigarette. And I'll, oh, I hate Shakespeare.
I think by now we sort of know you hate Shakespeare.
Shakespeare, the way he feigns humility when all he does is gloat. The way he wears that silly, frilly collar around his throat. The poster child for why no one should ever procreate. Let me make a shorter list, and I will give it to you straight. Every little thing about Shakespeare is what I hate.
He hates, he really,
don't hate! Nick! Do we still have a job?
Yeah, what's...
Yeah, we don't have a job.
Quiet! I'll take care of it. Come back tomorrow, and we'll have a new idea. New idea. New idea. We need a new idea.
Well, I still say we should tell our life story. Two orphaned brothers, their father lost at sea, whose mother died of a broken heart. You know how you, at age 14, carried me, your sickly little brother, all the way from Cornwall?
No! No, we need to think bigger. We need to innovate. The world is changing. I recently heard about a man who has a toilet that flushes.
Really? He doesn't just throw his shit in the street?
No. No, he pulls a lever, and he gets whooshed down a pipe. And then into the street. And that's what we need. Something new.
But that's what you're good at. No big ideas. I'm just a poet at heart. You know, you were doing so much better without me. Oh God, am I the problem?
No, no. Shakespeare is. God, why did I ever suggest he become a writer? I was just trying to get him out of our troupe because he was... so annoying. And now he's like this giant sun that
shines so bright, no other star is seen.
See? That's good. Which is why we write together. Now let's get to it.
Nicholas Bottom.
Dialogue. What are you doing in my house?
Your dead is due.
Oh, so I've hit a little setback with the play. But, if you give me another week, I'll name a character after you.
Too late! Shakespeare already promised me that. I can see it now. Shylock, the really nice Jew. He has a better offer. Cut me in as an investor in your play, and I'll cancel your debt.
But you're not a patron, you're a moneylender.
Because that's the only job they let Jews do! But you know what I really love? Oh, what puts the nachas in my puppet? The theater! I love it, 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 I love it! I love the sights, the smells, the roar of the crowd, the splat of the fruit as it hits the actors. It's a temple to me, I tell ya. A temple. Catholic, Protestant, Jew. I don't give a rat's tuchus. My religion is theater!
Wow. I mean, I had no idea. But I can't. If I let you invest, we'd both be hanged at Tyburn.
At least then you'd have an audience. Take the weekend. Mull it over. Because on Monday, your interest doubles.
Hello, darling. How's your day?
Interesting. I went to the stocks and I watched the mob throw cabbages at the criminals.
What'd you do that for? You hate all that.
Oh, I know. It was awful. Boiled cabbage?
I see.
Well, I think it's delicious.
Aw, thanks, Nige. There would have been meat, but the landlord came by demanding the rent. Took the last shilling right out of my hand. Oh, and then I was gonna surprise you guys with some mutton. Ooh, but sheep are fast.
You chase sheep? All right, that is it.
Oh, what are you doing?
I'm just gonna...
No. We've been through this. We do not touch the money box.
Come on, B. We shouldn't have to live like this. You deserve better.
And so do you. But that's what we're saving for. A better life. A new cottage in the countryside for me. You, a couple of kids, a room for Nigel and maybe his wife one day.
Stop it.
Now, I know it's been a while since we've put any money in there, and that's why I was thinking I should get a job.
What? No. If you get a job, that will just make me feel like a failure. None of the other writers' wives have jobs.
Well, they should. This is the 90s. We've got a woman on the throne, and by the year 1600, women will be completely equal to men. I just thought of the perfect job for me. I could be in your show.
What? You can't act. No, I didn't hurt your feelings.
Gotcha. See, I can act!
Yeah, you know it's illegal to put women on the stage!
And anyways, our play's been canceled.
What?
Not canceled. Nigel, that is such a negative way to put it. I mean, yes, we are no longer doing Richard II, but that is because we have a better idea.
Ooh, what is it?
Can't say. Don't want to jinx it.
So, there is no idea.
No. We have had the idea.
Ooh, that we need an idea.
Then let me help you. I'll go out, earn some money, and that'll take the pressure off you guys.
Bea, listen.
No, you listen. Because I just want to make things better. And I need to know that you understand. If you ever got in trouble, I would be there on the double just to bail you out. If there's anything you lack, you know I've always got your back. That's what it's all about. Think of me as your sidekick, helping you whenever I can. I'm more than just a woman, baby. When the pressure's coming, baby, let me be your right-hand man.
But you're not a man. I'm the man.
He's not your enemy. If you're ever in a pickle, you can call for me and quickle be how fast I run.
But I'm not in a pickle.
You and me should be a team for any dream or any scheme. That's how it should be done. Sure, I could stay in the background, just smiling every now and again. But just to be a pretty lady, that would be a pity, baby. Let me be your right-hand man.
You should probably listen. She's usually right.
Babe, you're cabbage.
Okay.
I am stronger than you think. Don't be thinking I ain't tough. Yeah. I am where you ought to go when the going's getting rough. So when things are going badly.
But they're not.
They kinda are.
No, things are fine.
But if they weren't.
But it's okay.
Love.
What?
Quit trying to protect me!
Change the subject, please!
Not until I know that if you're ever in a fix, and it's a fix you need to nix, then I'm your go-to guy.
You're not a guy!
So literal! And don't forget I'm not a shrinking violet, a solid rock am I! So don't be thinking I'll crumble when the you-know-what hits the fan! There's no problem that's too big when you're married, that's the gig. So don't be a sexist pig. Is it asking too much of you? It's only cause I love you. Let me be your right. In fact, I'll show you that I'm right.
What are you doing now?
I'm gonna get you boys some meat. I'm your right, don't put up a fight. I can be your right, sewed in here tonight. Let me be your right. Man. Let me be your right hand man.
Just happened.
Well, you know, I'd love to have someone do stuff like that for me. I mean, I think it's sweet.
It's humiliating. She goes out into the town square collecting old cabbage to feed us. What sort of husband am I? And that is why we need a new idea. One great idea could change everything. Oh, and we need it by tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Oh, no. I don't know if I can write under this sort of pressure.
Sorry, breathe. Breathe. It's okay. I'll see what I can come up with. And we'll start again tomorrow.
Okay. Sorry, brother.
I love you.
I love you too.
Get some sleep.
God, I hate Shakespeare. But when I sit and really contemplate Shakespeare, I guess I hate the fact that he is everything I ever dreamed that I could be. I mostly hate the way he makes me feel about me. 'Cause the truth is, it wouldn't be that bad to be Shakespeare. In fact, I'd give my left nad to be Shakespeare if I could only have one tiny little smidgen of his notoriety. It would relieve me of the pressures of responsibility. I've gotta make it happen. Gotta find that pot of gold. If there was just some way to know just what the future holds. What the future holds! I need more than luck.
Apple?
I'm looking for a soothsayer.
No, but for knowing, suppose it to be the best.
Closed due to unforeseen circumstances. So obviously not the very best.
Did I hear the need for future seeing? If seeing is what you need, then I can help you. If help is what you need, then I can see you. If neither is what you need, then
I can foresee you leaving very shortly. So, am I hired, actually? I know I will be. I'm just being polite.
Who are you?
I am Nostradamus.
The Nostradamus?
No, his niece Nancy.
Nancy Nostradamus?
I promise. But I share the same gifts as my esteemed uncle. And for half a crown, I can share those gifts with you. And I predict for you a new life. Ah! With no teeth! Ha! That was a freebie.
I'll keep looking if you don't mind.
Suit yourself, but beware the sign of the black door.
Right. Thank you. Good luck in the asylum.
Mm. Hey, watch it!
Half a crown, you say?
Excellent! Now, what is it that you would like the future to tell?
Well, I'm a writer.
I knew that.
And I want you to look into the future and tell me, what will the next big thing in theater be? What audiences will be lining up to see?
All right. Got it. Thank you. Blah, blah, blah. In the future, the theaters are very nice, yes! Oh, cushy red seats! Ah, oh, oh! And a roof! Oh. Oh! Oh, and what's this?
Yes?
Oh, it's unbelievable!
What?
That much for a glass of wine?
How about what's on the stage?
Right, right, getting to that. Thank you.
What?
The
what
biggest,
is it?
Most fantastic thing in theaters will be musicals.
What?
Musicals.
What the hell are musicals?
It appears to be a play where the dialogue stops and the plot is conveyed through song.
Through song?
Yes!
Wait, so an actor is just saying his lines, and all of a sudden he starts singing?
Yes!
Well, that is the stupidest thing that I have ever heard. You're doing a play, got something to say, so you sing it. It's absurd. Who on earth is going to sit there while an actor breaks into song? What possible thought could the audience think other than this is horribly wrong?
Remarkably, they won't think that.
Seriously? And why not?
Because it's a musical. A musical. And nothing's as amazing as a musical. With song and dance and sweet romance and happy endings happening by happenstance. Oh, bright lights, stage fights, and a dazzling chorus. You want to be great, then you gotta create a musical.
I don't know. I find it hard to believe that people would actually pay to see something like this.
Let's just say it's a Saturday night and you want to go on in the town. Got a lady to flatter who might give it up if you don't let her down. You could go see a tragedy, but that wouldn't be very fun. Or a play from Greek mythology. See a mother have sex with her son. Ooh. You could go see a drama with all that trauma and pain. Or go see something more relaxing and less taxing on the brain. Go see a musical. A musical! A puppy piece releasing all your musicals. Where crooners cool, catchy tune. And limber-legged ladies thrill your tilly a swoon. Oh! Who thought? Big applause and a standing ovation. The future is bright and you can just write a musical. Some make you happy, some make you sad. Some are quite big, some quite small. Some are too long, some are just like
No talking at all.
That's right. There's no talking. All of the dialogue is sung in a very dramatic fashion.
Really?
Yes, really.
There is no...
There's no talking. And they often stay on one note for a very long time, so that when you change to a different note, you notice. And it's supposed to create a dramatic effect, but mostly you just sit there asking yourself, why aren't they talking?
It sounds miserable.
I believe it's pronounced miserable.
And people actually like this stuff?
No. Oh, they love it! And what's not to love? It's such a delight. There's nothing quite like a musical. Oh, another vision! Oh, and I haven't even told you the best part yet! Feel that fascinating rhythm moving to your feet.
Whoa! Oh. What is that?
Feel your ass gyrating to that titillating beat.
Okay.
You slap your lap, then fingers snap. That's when you know it's time to tap. Oh!
What the hell are you doing now?
It's called a dance break. Apparently this happens in musicals as well. People on stage just burst into spontaneous dance.
Why? Does it advance the plot?
No.
Develop character?
Nope.
Then why do it?
Because it's entertaining! 5, 6, 7!
Thank you.
And you're sure that'll work?
Oh, sometimes. It works so well. You do the end of the exact same song. Again, a 5, 6, 7, 8.
A new big idea. Okay. Oh, for a muse of fire.
Oh, sorry. No, I wasn't looking where I was going.
Fault. I had my head in the. Is this a poem?
Uh huh.
Are you a poet?
Uh huh.
Oh, I love poetry and the way poets use lyrical language to express the beauty of life.
Uh huh.
Portia! Come away from that heathen at once!
Nigel! There you are, big news!
Me too! I think I'm in love!
You?
With who?
Wow! Guess a guy can only wait for so long.
Oh, not her! Her!
A Puritan? Are you mad? Do you know who her father is? Brethren! I say unto thee, the theaters are a scourge upon our land, where men dress as women and kiss other men. I have seen it myself, and it did stiffen my resolve. For such sinful roleplay is the gateway to lustful desires and fantasies of the flesh.
You really want that guy giving a speech at your wedding reception?
Let not thy sacred soul be poisoned by the poets and playwrights whose dark invention divents simple minds from the one true book. Come on, boys.
Forget about her. It will never work. Now, do you know that big idea we're looking for?
Well, I've got it.
You have?
Yes.
Now, I want you to listen with an open mind because it's a bit radical.
Okay, what is it?
A musical. It's a play with songs, but the songs advance the plot and develop character as they seamlessly segue from dialogue into singing.
That is the most
amazing idea!
Yeah. I mean, it's brilliant, actually. What better way to express the inner longings of the human soul than with music? And you're always writing songs on your lute.
I already dusted it off and started banging out a few tunes. And those poems of yours? There's your lyrics.
That's perfect. How did you come up with this?
That is not important.
But this is good, right?
Yeah. A musical. I love it.
Now we just need to figure out what it's going to be about.
Well, I still say we should tell our life.
Say, two brothers from Cornwall.
Why? I mean, we should write something that's emotionally true, something that comes from the heart.
No. No, we need to think bigger. Was the Bible written from the heart?
Well, I would hope so.
Okay, so it probably was. But my point is, Matthew, Mark, Luke, the rest of them, they were all writing about an event. Something big, epic, world-changing. I've got it. Yes, why didn't I think of this before?
What?
The biggest, most significant historical event in the past 1,000 years.
What's that coming up the Silk Road? Out of China, the Black Death.
Black Death! Whoa!
What's that creeping round your pee-pee and your vagina? The Black Death.
Black Death!
Whoa! The Black Death! It's gonna get you, it's the Black Death! It's gonna hit you with those blisters. Like syrup, that pesky little pestilence is killing half of Europe. It's the Black Death!
Black Death!
Black Death! Black Death. It's getting closer and it's making its way across England. Soon anything that's England won't be any good for England. It's a Black Death, and it's coming for you. Black Death!
Well, Milord,
what do you think?
They're singing.
Right, that's what you do in a musical.
But they're singing about the play.
I know. Shakespeare would never do something like this.
Because it's a terrible idea. You'll make me look ridiculous.
But I can guarantee you, everyone will love it.
Dick and Nigel Bottom!
Almost everyone.
Brother Jeremiah. To what do we owe the pleasure?
Pleasure is a sin. As is music, which I've heard emanating from this den of iniquity.
Den of iniquity? What makes you say that?
Hello.
As if theater wasn't enough. Now you've added music, which leads to dancing, which stirs the loins and promotes lustful desires. Which is why we must see these theaters pulled down, for we cannot abide by such ungodly erections. As a magistrate, I have much influence with the Master of Justice, so you listen to this, Bottom. If you continue to promote this filth and debauchery, I will see you die to a post, begging for mercy as I give you the rod.
Ooh.
Good day, sir!
That's it. I'm out.
Wait.
I'm sorry, gentlemen, but these religious nutters frighten me. I must withdraw my patronage. Good day.
I can't believe that just happened.
You should have been a better reaper. Your reaping was shot.
No.
Calm down. I'm on it.
Our patron! This is really bad! What are we supposed to do?
So we're gonna
have
a
good
time. Walk it off.
Okay.
Is he? Alright.
Yep. God, watch it, you daft DJ!
Sorry, sir. Beg your pardon.
Oi, darlings. Buy your pint, eh? A?
B?
Don't know what you're talking about, lad. My name's Johnny.
B, I know it's you.
But I fooled you for a second, didn't I? See, I told you I could act.
What the hell are you doing dressed like that?
Oh, remember that job I mentioned earlier? Turns out all the good ones are for men. Oh, and besides, I know you needed my help because you said I don't need your help.
B, this just makes me feel... Is that a bucket of shit?
Bear shit, to be precise. Oh, and I've been promoted. This morning, I didn't have a bucket. Oh, and look, I've already earned a penny. I'm gonna go put it in the money box.
No! I'll do it.
Yo, bear shit boy!
Hear that? I've got a job title, and one day it'll be bear shit woman. Keep writing. I love you, love.
Nick! What are we gonna do? This is really bad. We don't have
to make it. Keep writing. I'll be back.
What, alone?
Nigel, I need you now more than ever. I'm gonna go find us a new backer, which means that you need to come up with a new idea. Please tell me I can count on you for that.
Yes, you can! Yes, you can. No, you can't. Good day, mistress.
Good days were those were lit with love till dusk of death did herald the eternal night.
Hey, I wrote that.
I know! I accidentally took this from our last encounter.
your sonnet. It's perfection.
Really? You thought it was good?
It touched me in places I did not know could be touched. Ooh, forgive me. Poetry is forbidden in my household, especially poems of earthly love. Oh, is there no pity sitting in the clouds that sees into the bottoms of my grief?
Romeo and Juliet, Act 3, Scene 5.
You've seen it?
6 times, and you?
8. My father would disown me if he knew.
My brother, too.
I adore Shakespeare.
Me too. You know, I've got a Comedy of Errors, first edition.
I've got Sonnet number 1, Sigh!
Wow!
I know!
Well, that's awesome.
You know, I think you're his equal, if not better.
What? No way!
Oh, yes, your sonnet has Shakespearean sophistication mixed with the complexity of Daniel Webster and the sensitivity of Samuel Daniel.
Wow. You really love poetry.
Oh, I do. I really, really do. I love Sidney and Marlowe, and often I borrow their words to express how I feel. I love poems of mystery, fantasy, history, oh, and seductive appeal. At night, alone in my bed, satisfying my need, the candlelight fire ignites my desire to read. Oh, every time I hear a perfect rhyme, I get all tingly. Because I know that to find a perfect rhyme is not an easy thing. I love the places that words let me go. I love the way that your words move me so. No words have touched me the way that yours do. And I love you. You are really doing something to me, Mr. Poetry Man, forgive me, I never get to discuss poems in this way.
Well, oh, it's okay. I never knew poetry could affect someone the same way it affects me.
Me neither.
It's the end, all the be all, oh, you want to see all the books that I have on my shelf.
Me too. I find pleasure perusing those writings and musing. So often I pleasure myself. Wait, that didn't sound right.
No, I know what you mean. When I'm deep in the throes of impassioned prose, I could scream.
You scream? So do I! Oh, I love a little line of lyrical alliteration.
Who doesn't love alliteration?
And I'm like, whoa, when the phrases come together like a consummation.
I love the places that words let me go. I love the way that your words move me so. I love that you feel the same way I do. And I love you. I want to show you something. So I've kept this hidden from my brother. It's a letter to me from the bard, you know, saying he's received my sonnet.
You sent Shakespeare your sonnet? And he read it?
Well, I mean, he said he would.
You know Shakespeare?
Kind of. He was in my brother's acting troupe, but I mean, I was just a little kid then. I mean, it's not like he knows who I am or anything.
Master Nigel Bottom?
Yes?
An invitation for Master Shakespeare to be his personal guest at a recitation in the park.
Shakespeare in the park! Oh, can she be my +1?
We want that! We want
Ladies and gentlemen, all the way from Stratford-upon-Avon, the king of couplets, the sultan of sonnets, the man who put the I am in iambic pentameter, put your hands together for the one, the only, William Shakespeare!
Hands back for all of you beautiful tutors out there. A little short of this bit.
I love you.
Very good to me. Let's see if you all know it. Shall we? Shall I compare thee
to a summer day?
Yeah, thou one was lovely and we're separate. And the rough wind shakes the darling buds of May, yeah. And summer's lease.
I call too short a date.
Oh, I adore the adoration, though I'm dismayed of all. It's quite a new sensation. What shall we call it?
Will power.
I am the will of the people.
He is the will of the people.
Can you feel it? Oh, I'm feeling it too. In fact, I'd like to feel you a little bit later. Do you want more?
Yes!
I want it tomorrow.
No!
Later.
No!
Let me hear you say now.
Now!
Very nice. Let me hear you say now is.
Now is.
That stands. Let me hear you say now is the.
Happy song.
Oh, do it with me. Now is the winter of our discontent.
Now is the winter of our
discontent. There we go. Make glorious summer by this son of yours.
Make glorious summer by this son of yours.
Let me hear you say glorious.
Glorious.
Do you mean me?
Glorious.
No, I can't be.
Glorious.
Let me see G-L-O-R-I-O-U-S. Who fits that bill?
It's Will.
Yes. There's a fever going around. Has anybody caught it?
We're shaking it for Shakespeare.
He thinks you've got it. To my ears, and if music be the food of love, then play on. That's a new one, I don't even know where to put it now. Speaking of love. Yes, gather round, thank you.
But soft was light through yonder window grey.
Thank you.
It is the east. And Juliet is the sun, arise, fair sun, and kill the envious moon.
Oh, the moon.
Who is already sick and pale.
Get off!
So sick and so pale with grief. Thou her maid, art far more fair than she.
Oh, hello.
Then she.
Will power.
Will power. Will power.
Blood clot. We are no longer doing Black Death. So please reconsider investing.
No, I'm not speaking to you. You ruined Romeo and Juliet. Now I'm off to see Richard III.
Oh, really? Richard can't find his horse and then he dies.
Oh, stop it! Stop it!
Hey, new block! You up for this or not?
Oh, don't worry about me. I'm as strong as the next guy.
B, what are you doing? I told you to cut this out.
Well, they were looking for big, strong men to haul the stage away. Why aren't they ever looking for big, strong women?
Because some jobs are just better suited for men. Now give me that. Oh, my God, that is... Okay. Are you okay?
Actually, I was gonna tell you the news when you got home. You know those wild mood swings I've been having?
No.
Yes, you do! I told you about them! There's a reason for them.
Oh God, you've got the plague.
No. I'm pregnant.
You're sure it's not the plague?
No! Isn't it wonderful?
It is. It's great news. Oh, it's okay. We're having a baby together.
Oh, Nick! You're gonna be a father. A family just like we've always wanted. Oh, now we're gonna need that country cottage more than ever.
I'm working on it.
And so am I. Better get to it.
No. You go home and rest.
Thanks. I love you.
I love you too. I'm gonna be a father. I'm gonna be a father.
So! Ready to reconsider my offer now?
No, Shylock.
Because you're prejudiced against the Jew.
Not me. All of Renaissance Europe. And besides, I've already got a Puritan saying my writing's the work of Satan and I should burn in hell.
Don't listen to the critics. They're for Cocta. Come on, Nick. Be a mensch. Let me help you.
I'm not that desperate.
Oh, really? You have no show, no patron. Oh, and your brother's at a private party for William Shakespeare.
What? Oh, I'll kill him.
It's invitation only. And guess who has an invitation?
Shakespeare! Shakespeare!
Thank you. That is not water!
Oh my God, it's Thomas Middleton!
And he's talking to Edmund Spenser! And oh my gosh, look who just walked in!
Francis Bacon! Wow! I mean, it's like all of London's greatest writers are right here in this room.
Including you!
Is that the young bottom I see?
Shakespeare!
Yes, yes, it is me. Hello. I'll be seeing you later. So, Nigel Bottom, playwright, poet, prestigious prodigy. Ooh, lots of alliteration. Occupational hazard. So, Nicky Bottom's little brother, his secret weapon all grown up. And who is this delightful damsel? This maiden fair, this feast for the eyes.
Oh, this is Portia.
Portia? Good name. Oh, that's right, this is happening. Just breathe, baby, breathe.
Master Shakespeare!
Oh, she's bedazzled. Do you like that word? I just made it up. It's what I do. Let's drink to that.
Huzzah!
I think I need a little bit of a lie down.
So, Nigel, what are you and that brother of yours working on? A tragedy, a comedy, a tragic attempt at comedy. Do you see what I did there? Do you see what I did there?
Well, you know, Nick doesn't want me to tell anyone what we're working on.
Oh God, he is so paranoid. And you know, he always has been. Even when I was just a sad little actor in his pathetic little troupe, he was always so insecure. And with you as his partner, he has ever more reason to be. I've read your sonnet. And it's good, Nigel. It is quite good. I would love to read it. Is that your folio?
No, this is just a random collection of some lines and thoughts.
Would you like me to give it a looky-loo? Oh, who am I kidding? Of course you would. I'm Shakespeare.
Shakespeare!
All the world's a stage. Good line.
Hey, hey! You're not allowed in here!
It's okay. He's my plus one.
Trust me, I have no desire to stay. I'm just looking for my brother. What the hell are you? Oh. Hello, Will.
Oh, hello, Nick. Been quite a long time.
Not long enough. Is that my brother's notebook?
No.
Nice try.
He was just offering to look at my lines.
Huh. Or his lines, as they'd soon be known.
Do you bite your thumb, sir?
Really? Quoting Romeo and Juliet? Pathetic.
Oh, well, by my troth, the tartness of his face doth sour the ripened grape.
Oh, yeah? Well, by my troth, your grape is stupid.
Oh.
Aw, such a clever retort. And you still can't write a hit? No. We should be thanking this man. He was the one who suggested I take up writing in the first place.
Because you're a shit actor.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you
no,
are.
No, I'm not. Take it back.
Out of my way, heathen. Whoa. Where is she? Where is my daughter? Portia.
Hello, Daddy-o.
Portia, what are you doing here? You said you were in your room reading your Bible.
Oh, bibble, Bible, babble, bibble.
You dare to cross me and corrupt my daughter? So help me God, I will smite these bottoms and smite them hard. Come with me.
Smite their bottoms.
Portia,
you come with me.
Oh, what? Let me go. I'm not a child.
Then why are you acting like one? I tell you to stay away from her, and now look what's happened. We're on the most wanted list of a deranged Puritan. And Shakespeare almost got your notebook full of ideas, which, by the way, is the only reason he invited you here.
No!
You are so naive. You've got to watch your back around that guy. Believe me, I know every trick in his book.
Well, it was all very confusing. And now she's gone, and I've lost my inspiration and the love of my life. And I've got to get her back. Portia!
Nigel!
So, ready to reconsider my offer now?
You know what? Why the hell not? Let's do it.
Really? Mazel tov! I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it!
So, what's our new play about?
Well, we're still looking for that great idea.
Too bad you can't get a peek into Shakespeare's notebook, huh?
I knew you'd be back.
Really?
No. But it sounds impressive, doesn't it? So, how goes it with your musical?
Not great, actually. We're still trying to figure out what a musical should be about.
Hair!
Hair?
No. That'd be weird, wouldn't it? Little Shop of Horrors?
Really? That doesn't sound right either.
I know. Why is the shop little? Small whores?
Look,
Look, the truth is, I'm desperate. I need something that is guaranteed to be a hit. Something that'll have them lined up around the theater. So I want you to look into the future and tell me, what will Shakespeare's greatest play be?
Are you sure you want me to cross that line? Wouldn't you rather just come up with an idea on your own?
Of course I would. I've tried, and I can't. And maybe if I had more time or less pressure, but I just need one hit to get me out of this hole.
I must warn you, for this you will pay a great price.
I brought every penny I have.
Not what I meant, but okay.
And you're sure this will work? Because I have everything riding on this. And now I've got a baby on the way.
Which I predicted, remember? A new life with no tea? Excellent! Okay, Shakespeare's biggest play. Here we go. Thank you. Shakespeare's greatest hit!
Yes!
The one they will be talking about for generations to come!
Yes!
And the play will be called... Omelet.
Omelet? Like with eggs?
Yes. No, wait. No, yes, omelet, that's it. And wait. Something Danish?
A Danish? So there's a breakfast theme.
Wait, okay. Ham. Hamler. Hamler. Ham something.
Ham omelets?
That must be it.
And you're sure this will be big?
It will be known as perhaps the single greatest play ever written.
Yes.
I'm getting a flood of images. Oh, so many.
Write them down. All of them.
Let me go get my quill.
Oh, man. This is going to solve so many problems. My future is suddenly looking brighter. No more Mr. Anonymous. No more world that is Nick Bottomless. My name will be synonymous with being on the top. I can see it now. I'm the cat's meow. It's a hit, pal. It's gonna be great, it's gonna be great. Everywhere I go, they will love me so. Hail my name, oh, it's gonna be great, it's gonna be great.
Master Bob, you're such a wonderful writer.
Oh, I can hear them now.
And your talent is out beyond the mirror.
Why, thank you.
You're a starting heart, it could be brighter.
Yeah, it was embarrassing me.
You're a real visionary.
Thank you, Jesus, and Hail Mary.
This bottle's gonna be on top. This bottle's gonna be on top.
This is heaven sent, feeling confident, money well spent. It's gonna be great, gonna be great. Throw a big parade, praises will be made, compliments paid. It's gonna be great, gonna be great.
Yeah, babe, you're so eternally grateful.
You're who I'm doing it for.
Thank you for our cottage in the woods.
You deserve it.
If gratitude was food, I'd have a big platform.
Nice metaphor, bro.
You decorate it.
You demand.
I really shouldn't say it, but yes, I am.
This bottle's gonna be on top. This bottle's gonna be on top.
Once again, you're on the top.
And this bottle's gonna be on top.
There's also a ghost and a prince. Murder most foul.
Write down everything you see. Because I see me. I'm not a bird. I'm the bird.
We are the royalty of the Renaissance writers.
Indeed you are.
Now we're handing down the crown to you.
Why, thank you.
You were nobody but an old
someone better than the rest of us. Now you are the best of us.
Not so fast.
Hello, Will. I knew you wouldn't go down without a fight.
The top, sir, nay, thou surely doth jest. I say on my honor here, I doth protest.
Yawn, rhyming couplet? That is so 1580s.
Oh, yeah. Well, if you want to make it to the top, then you're gonna have to go through me. Cause on the top is where I live, and I will not be giving up so easily. So there.
Oh man, I have been waiting for this moment for so long, I'm gonna enjoy it when I knock you off your perch.
Oh no, you won't.
Oh yes, I will.
Oh no, you won't.
Oh yes, I will.
Oh no, you won't.
Oh yes, I will.
Oh no, you won't. My accomplishments are much more accomplished than yours.
In your dreams, I am the best.
You can't be the best because I am the best. I have written 12 plays and each one is a testament to my great skill. I am the will. And I will taming of the shrew and Richard 3 and Richard 2 and Henry 4 and 5 and 6. And Titus Andronicus. And oh, did I forget? Romeo and Juliet.
Well, I have just written the thing that the critics are calling the greatest thing they've ever seen. The people are loving it, can't get enough of it. Everyone, even including the queen. She recently invited me to her castle. She invited me. And privately, she told me that you're not any good, not any good, not any good, not any good. And she told me that all of your plays make her vomit, and nothing's as good as my musical Omelet.
Wait a minute. You wrote Omelet?
Yes.
I never thought that I would meet my equal, but I concede I have been bested by the best. Maybe we could partner on a sequel.
Oh my, how the tide has turned. Let's review. What have we learned? See, you were here, but now we've swapped, so kiss this bottom, I'm on the top. Well, I am, brother. So raise a glass to Omelet, the musical. Bottoms up.
Bottoms up. Yeah, these bottoms will be on top.
chance. Now the stage is set for a huge response or an epic failure, and Nick and Nigel Bottom are starting to sweat, 'cause they don't have the story written yet. Welcome to the Renaissance. Gotta give the audience what it wants, but it's not that easy. And if you're William Shakespeare, you're feeling the heat to still be new. Welcome to the Renaissance. What's a famous bard to do?
Hello. Did you miss me? I'll keep going. My days are so busy, it's making me dizzy. There's so much I've gotta do. It's lunches and meetings and poetry readings and endless interviews. Gotta pose for a portrait and how I deplore sitting there for eternity. Then it's off to the inn where my innkeeper friend wants to name a drink after me. But then back to my room where I resume my attempts to write a hit. It's just me, my beer, and this terrible fear that I might be losing it. 'Cause it's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard, it's really, it's really hard.
So
very, very hard.
Well, I make it look easy, but darling, believe me, it's hard.
It's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard.
It's so incredibly hard.
So inconceivably, unbelievably hard.
No, it's hard to be the bard. I mean, honestly, I don't even know how I do it. There's only so much of me to go around. I've got so many fans and so many demands, I can hardly go take a piss. Be a theater freaker, the autograph seeker, they all want a piece of this.
Give me.
It's a cross that I bear, I'm like Jesus, I swear I word it, but I suffer through it.
It's
a part of the game, the trappings of fame, and someone's gotta do it.
So he does
but
it.
I know, I've gotta go and get back to my pen and ink. Ooh. No, it's not making you do it, don't make me go through it. Can somebody get me a drink? 'Cause
It's hard, it's really hard.
Oh, it's
sexy, but it's hard.
But this bar that I'm raising to be this amazing is
hard. It's hard, it's hard,
it's so
annoyingly hard.
So
unavoidably, unenjoyably hard.
Oh, it's hard to be the bard, baby. I mean, yes, writing is what made me famous, but let's be honest, being famous is more fun. See, what people just don't understand is that writing's demanding, it's mentally challenging, and it's a bore, such a chore, to sit in a room by yourself, oh my god, I just hate it. And you're trying to find an opening line or a brilliant idea, and you're pacing the floor, and you're searching for, I mean, just a divine intervention. That one little nugget, that one little spark, and you think you've got it, you're ready to start. So now you can write, right? Wrong, you're not even close, you remember, damn it, your play's gotta be an iambic pentameter. So you write down a word, but it's not the right word, and you try a new word, but you hate a new word, and you need a new word, but you can't find the word. Oh, what is it, where is it, when is it, why is it, how is it?
You know what I think?
What? Please, enlighten me.
I think you're a petulant little boy, and a fraud.
Shut up, mother!
Master Shakespeare! You've asked for information on what Nicholas Bottom is writing? And our spy is here with news.
Did she see me losing it?
Well, she's half blind, sir.
Oh. So she only saw half of it. Do you see what I did? Speak, woman, what news?
I saw Nick Bottom, I did. He paid a soothsayer to foresee what Shakespeare's greatest play would be.
That sneaky little thief. Why doesn't he come up with his own ideas?
It's hard.
No, really it is. It's really the word.
It's hard.
It makes me wonder why I didn't think of that word.
It's hard
to alleviate this pressure to create.
It's hard.
They don't think it's good, it's the last thing I knew that was already bad.
It's hard. The part that he is stealing from the bar.
Well, I'll voice the right to its time. All that I need is a clever disguise. Tedious stuff, the word that's terribly hard, the terribly hard. All right, Shakespeare. I think it's time for Shakespeare to find my next hit.
It's hard.
I'm fortunate in fame, everyone knows my name, I can't help it. It's still freaking hard.
So just to make sure we've got this all straight, mm-hmm. we've got a prince, mm-hmm. and he is eating a Danish, mm-hmm. and he's visited by the ghost of his dead father.
Not the ghost, the phantom. He was the former king, and he was murdered by the prince's uncle. And the uncle's name is... Scar!
Scar. And he killed the king.
Yes.
And the prince is in love, but she goes mad, you said.
Yes. And how do we solve a problem like Ophelia?
Right, how do you?
The prince says, get thee to a nunnery! And all the nuns hide her and all the singing children from the Nazis!
And these Nazis, are they good guys or bad?
I'm not sure. But it feels important to get that one right.
Oh, they're back. Okay, remember, stay right here and don't say anything.
All right.
I love it. Zylark, just in time. Have a seat, we're about to start.
I love it.
You haven't seen it yet.
I know, but I just love being here. I'm verklempt, I tell ya.
Nick, isn't it illegal to have a Jewish patron?
Oh, well, he's not a patron. He's producing money for the production to get produced. So, we call him a... Well, we haven't thought of a title for it yet. All right, everyone, let's take it from the top. Watch and weep, Shakespeare. Watch and weep.
What's that cooking on the griddle? Burned up and beaten. It's eggs,
it's eggs, woo!
Throw some fixins in the middle. So good for eating. It's eggs, woo!
The scrambled nature of my soul. I'm cracking up as I begin to see the bits of me within this.
Omelet. I'm sorry, can I jump in here? What the hell was that?
Well, I told you there'd be singing.
But they're singing about eggs?
It's a metaphor. The griddle is his mind. What's he thinking about? Eggs. The symbol of life. But he's cracking up. His thoughts are scrambled. Like an egg.
Yeah, I'm not getting any of that.
Yeah, I'm not either. And I'm the one who wrote this. I mean, what's a fiddler and why is he on the roof?
Well, because that's where the chimney is. Quit overthinking it.
I'm just thinking about the audience. You know, the people coming in from Jersey.
Jersey?
It's in the Channel Islands, next to Guernsey.
Oh!
I mean,
people. They've worked hard all week long. They don't want metaphors. They want good old-fashioned frivolous entertainment.
Cats!
What?
A whole stage. Covered with singing cats! No way. No, yes, that's right, singing cats.
Who's the nut job?
I told you, musicals need a big company. She's our scribe.
Yeah, I don't know, Nick. Something about this just doesn't feel right. Right, guys?
Yeah, yeah, really. Yeah, like, so that, like, so like, so I want to...
Oi up, lads. My name is Toby Belch. I'm a humble actor from York. And I come seeking an audition from the Bottom Brothers.
That's us.
Oh, well, it is an honor. I hear that you two are creating something incendiary, monumental, bigger than Shakespeare.
You hear that, guys? That's right. Toby, wasn't it?
From York.
Well, we are making something pretty special. It's a play full of songs about an omelet.
That's the great idea.
What?
I said, that's a great idea. Here is my head sketch and resume.
Hey, wait a minute. You been in every one of my plays.
Oh, well, I am such a big fan. And I think it is so unfair that Shakespeare gets all the money and the attention and the money. Oh, so much money. When your plays are in a league all of their own.
I like the New York actor. You're hired. Gents, meet your newest cast member, Toby Belch. Teach him the song. And where are you going?
Oh,
we have a whole second act to sort out.
I have other ideas I need to explore.
Let's not go through this again, Nigel. This is the idea. Omelet.
Yes, and I already told you that something about this just doesn't feel right. And besides, I have something I need to go write on my own.
Oh, I get it. You want to go see her, don't you? Well, that is not going to happen. No. Nigel, stay. Don't! That girl!
You go!
Portia!
Nigel, you came! I had to climb out of a window, but I don't think anyone saw me.
Okay. Now, are you sure you want to do this?
Yes.
Because we don't have to if you don't want to.
No, I want to. I'm just nervous.
Well, me too. Is here okay? Oh. Okay. Ode to Portia by Nigel Bottom. Like stars and sun together, never seen the heaven to me, so much of the time tonight.
Whoa. Slow down.
Sorry. Guess I'm more nervous than I thought. Can I try it again?
Mm-hmm.
Like stars and sun together, never seen. Yet heaven made us one, our flames to shine.
Oh, God.
Through night and day, no dusk or dawn between, yet none could dim our light nor love divine.
Mm-hmm.
Astronomers, behold these starry eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Forbidden love, bid secret hearts beat
keep
loud.
Going.
And laws of man are stately love denied.
Don't stop.
And laws of nature is our love allowed.
Yes.
And to the stars will fly the elusive enough to heaven's gate with my eternal love. You mean instead of omelets? I know. I mean, that just doesn't feel right.
Then don't write it. Write what's in here, and it'll move others as it has moved me.
But will it move your father? And change his mind? You know he doesn't approve of us.
Neither does your brother. Who does that make us star-crossed?
Wait. That's not a good thing. I mean, we both know how that story ends with... You know, me drinking poison and you with a dagger in your heart.
Maybe it doesn't have to. Maybe we can write a different ending. I'm tired of listening to the same sad story. How lovers fail because it's written in the stars. This feuding family plot is starting to bore me. I'm thinking we can show them that's not who we are. It may take a little more persuading for those who think it's better that we are apart. I have no doubt their doubts will soon be fading. We'll show them how true love finds a way. Even though I know what they'll say.
No, that won't do. God has plans for you.
From your heart.
If love is a sickness, then find me no cure, for 'tis only love that I know to be pure.
Aww. And then they'll think about it. And pray about it.
Yeah!
It'll open! And they'll be sitting in a different room.
We see the light to change how we're thinking. Cause we were blind, but you showed us the way. We're wrong, you're right. Salvation is yours if you do what is true to you. And you do it with
I do not approve.
But I know you'll win him over. His heart is gonna sing, and he'll love you when you do your thing. Go on, do it, do it right now, do it.
If love is love purely, then let me
go on, do it.
That all
go on, do it right now,
his
yeah.
Good God,
you
all I see the light. You
changed how he's thinking, cause he is
always blind. You showed me the way. To judge these two.
So true, preach it.
He's a writer, he's doing what he can.
What he can.
Got a rubber preacher man.
Oh.
And they got the right, and they got the right, and they got the right to be together.
I need no further proof.
These words, they speak the truth.
And the truth will set you free.
Set you free.
When you do what is true to you, and you do it.
Wait, read.
Aww.
Yay!
Think that could happen?
Yes! Once my father sees that your heart is true, he will love you just as much as I do.
Boucha! There you are, you daughter of Eve!
Please, Father!
You bid me grant Eve so you could pray forgiveness in the church! And instead you slither off here to sate your lustful desires!
Read it, read your poem!
If love is a
okay. You will tempt my daughter no more. She will be locked in the church tower, and there she will stay until her exile to our brethren in Scotland.
No! Right from your heart, Nigel!
I will, I promise.
I love you!
I'm
warning you, boy. You leave her be, or you will pay dearly.
Portia!
Oh, what good is living when life is so cruel, and my destiny is to be fortune's fool? If my pen be my one and my only companion, let it speak for my soul. Let it speak for my soul. Sure as the day follows the night, sure as the sky turns to blue, this much I know, this much is true, Above all else, in whatever you do, to thine own self be true.
I'm still working out some of the kinks, but if we could take it from the Prince's soliloquy, Peter.
To be or not to be, that is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to bear arms against the sea of troubles.
Wow, this is some really good shit, mate. If we could go from your entrance, Robin, we'll just keep going. Yeah.
Oh, that this too solid flesh would melt, thaw, and resolve into a dew.
Frailty, thy name is woman. Get thee to a nunnery.
Hold thy tongue, fair prince.
Thy lady doth protest too much, methinks.
Ah, what the hell?
Nick! Your brother has written something truly amazing.
It's better than Shakespeare.
Is it though?
You wrote something and didn't even run it by me?
Well, Nick, you gave me all of these ridiculous ideas, so I took the ones that actually made sense and wrote something that rings true in here.
Oh, God.
Can you not do that? I mean, could you just listen, please? Okay, so it's about a prince. And he's not eating a Danish, he is Danish. And he's full of anguish for a great loss. And he realizes his own life has no real meaning. And I mean, he's so depressed that he wants to kill himself, but you know, he can't even make up his mind about that. And then his true love is forced into a religious exile where, I mean, she probably dies of a broken heart. And then he descends into madness, and he dies, and everyone dies, and the whole stage is covered in bodies and blood and death, and the rest is silence. And they're all left to die, to sleep. To sleep, perchance, to dream.
That's the great idea.
It has nothing to do with eggs!
Yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking. Why don't I hold these for safekeeping?
Nick, you're not thinking clearly here. I mean, read this, it's good!
I am reading, and where's the omelet?
There is no omelet.
What do you mean, there's no omelet? There has to be an omelet!
Why does there have to be an omelet?
Because it's called omelet?
Well, why does it have to be called omelet?
It just does, okay? You need to trust me on this one.
He's not hearing me.
Just read him what you wrote.
Why? He clearly won't listen.
Nigel, I should really take these before things turn ugly.
Just read it. Nick, I mean, something happened last night, and I promised to write what I feel, and here it is.
Sure as the day follows the night, sure as the sky turns to blue, this much I know, this much is true. Above all else, in whatever you do, to thine own self be true.
I love that.
It's good line and good advice.
You know, I'm not quite so sure. I really liked the breakfast theme. Everybody loves breakfast.
Exactly. But there's no ham, there's no eggs. You are completely ignoring the theme.
I'm ignoring the breakfast theme because it's ridiculous.
Oh, so my idea's wrong, but this whole true to yourself thing is right?
It's not just a line. It's what I believe.
Then you're a fool if you think life is as simple as that.
Well, I do.
Well, I don't.
This is hopeless.
You should really listen, Nick. It just makes your heart want to soar. Come on, guys. We got this.
Sure as the day follows the night, sure as the sky turns to blue, this much I know, this much is true, this much is true. Above all else, in whatever we do,
to thine own self,
be true. Thine own self be true.
Where's the omelet?
Wow. I mean, what has happened to you? I mean, what happened to the brother who had integrity, who inspired me to become a writer?
He finally had a great idea. And I can tell you for a fact, it will be known as the single greatest play ever written.
How could you possibly know that?
I just do. And we don't have time for this. We open in a week. Are you gonna help me write Omelet or not?
No.
No?
I can't. It just doesn't feel right. And you know, deep down, I don't think it feels right to you either.
You know, it must be so nice to always do what you feel, because you have no one to take care of but yourself. And that's why I never wanted to do that brother who carried you from Cornwall story. Because I'm still carrying you. And I'm sick of it.
Well, then why don't I just get off your back?
No, the script! I need it!
I've got news! Your show, Omelet, it's not selling any tickets! Because we've sold out! They lined up around the block.
What audiences will be lining up to see?
Told ya!
So what'll it be, guys? Do you want to write something meaningful and artistic?
Of course, we are.
Do you want to write a massive hit and actually make some money? So let's give them what they're hungry for. Omelet the Musical. We're on our way to glory. We'll play for kings and queens. And there and then you'll see the ends will justify the means.
The ends will justify the means. Sure as the day follows the night.
Surely we must see this through.
Okay, say so.
Damned if I don't. Damned if I do. But damn it, I don't have the luxury to hang all my hope on some simplistic trope. Like, to thine own self.
Portia, I did what you said. And look what happened.
Oh, hello, Nigel. It's me. Well, fancy meeting you here. What a complete and utter coincidence. Is that the Bottom Brothers' new play?
No, this is something I tried to write on my own.
May I?
Sure.
When sorrows come, they come not in single spies, but in battalions. God.
What, it's bad?
No, it's derivative, Nigel.
Really? I mean, you're serious.
Yes, this has all been done quite many times. I mean, to be or not to be, what a piece of work is man, it's cliché. You know, at the end of the day, I just would never want to see this with your name on it. But that musical of yours, Omelet. Oh, I have been telling everyone, they simply must go see it.
Why? I mean, it's so...
It's so bold. So daring. Yes, I completely agree, Nigel. A lesser writer would shy away, but would you? Write that, not this. That, not this. Write your omelet.
Write your omelet? Write what?
Oh, we're so fun. We have to do this again sometime. Oh, Nigel! The ladies just threw me a party and got me the sweetest gifts for the baby. Oh, look what Helena gave me to help the baby sleep.
Whiskey!
Oh, and Miranda gave me this to help with the delivery.
It's a stick to bite on, see?
Yeah, that's gonna hurt too. Oh, hey, how's the show going?
Well, you'd have to ask Nick.
I'll catch up with you guys later. What's wrong?
Well, we got into a fight, and he said some things. I mean, he said he was carrying me.
Oh no.
Yeah. And that really hurt. And you know, it makes me think that maybe we shouldn't work together anymore.
Aha. Nige, do you know the poem Love is a Shitload of Work?
No.
That's because the poets never write about what love is really like. Believe me, try being married for 10 years. It's not all summer's days and sweet-smelling roses. It's more like, shall I compare thee to a horse's ass? Look, I'll admit, I've never seen him like this before. He's under a lot of pressure and doing some really stupid things. Keeping stuff to himself, saying hurtful things, taking all of our savings from the money box.
What?
Oh, yeah. Still waiting to see how that love poem's gonna turn out. But what stops us from walking out on him? I think it's 'cause you know, like I know. If you ever got in trouble, he would be there on the double just to bail you out. If there's anything you lack, you know he's always got your back. That's what he's all about. He has his faults, but he means well, and he always does the best that he can. And it should be understood, I wouldn't change him if I could, 'cause I know his heart is good, and he'll always be your right-hand man. He can't do this without you. Maybe it's time you carry him for a change.
Okay. I will.
Great! I can't wait to see what the two of you have come up with, and I'm sure you'll give them a show they'll never forget.
Alas, poor yoke, I knew thee well. There's something rotten. There's something rotten. You can smell it, you can tell it's something rotten. Now the kingdom is shut and it's all gone to pot. Heaven help us, there is something rotten. Frailty, thy name is A. How like thee I am, for I am what I am, and what I am doth be an illusion.
You beckoned, my lord?
Where is McCavity?
At the Jellicle Ball. He would not come.
Go and fetch him.
Alas, my lord, what vexes thee?
I dreamed a dream, Horatio. An impossible dream. There were wheels upon yon dream, and raindrops on Rosencrantz, and whiskers on his kitten.
What be the meaning of it?
We've got trouble.
Trouble?
Trouble, I say. My father lies dead, and the serpent that did sting his life now wears his crown. Where is McCavity?
McCavity's not there.
Soon!
Oh, I could have danced all night. Gentle prince, thine absence 'twas worrisome for the king and I.
If mama weren't married, 'twould not be so.
Where be the king?
Good man, what news?
The Nazis! They're here!
The Nazis?
Huzzah!
Oh, the Nazis are such good and honest men. With their help, we shall surely wage war against the Puerto Ricans.
Tonight!
Oh, luck be a lady tonight.
He wears the crown that should adorn my head. God, I hope I get it.
Ladies and gentlemen,
willkommen, bienvenue, welcome.
The wedding breakfast is served.
My father newly dead,
and now the funeral boiled eggs doth coldly furnish forth the marriage table.
Methinks another chef might have whisked our disparate eggs together as one.
Nephew, what dost thou mean?
Well, I'll tell you. The fruit of life can't always taste like sweet persimmons. Sometimes it's hard to swallow, I'm afraid. But when life has handed you some lemons, then hand it back a mug of lemonade. My father said this to me, that he did, and then he blew me
away with wisdom simple and concise.
He said, Egbert, life is merely what you make of it. So heed this sound advice. You make wine from sour grapes. You got a flat pancake, just call it a crepe. When life gives you eggs, make an omelet. You got cola from a nut. A dirty worm makes silk from out of its butt. When life gives you eggs, make an omelet, omelet.
The solution to your troubles is cheese and vegetables. And make an omelet,
yeah. When it looks like you should quit, find another way of looking at it.
When life gives you eggs, you gotta make the
thank you.
Though this may appear madness, there be method in it. Simple truths of...
Nephew, what dost thou mean? I have a quick question.
Fair Uncle Scar. Why dost thou speakest when thou shouldn't speakest?
Because I want to know, how canst thou make an omelet when one of the eggs be rotten?
Is this in the script?
Therein lies the problem. The rotten one is you.
Toby.
Or not Toby! That is the question!
Will Shakespeare?
You little snake!
And you said I was a shit actor.
I will not let you make an ass of me!
Oh, relax, Nick. You've done a fine job yourself.
Nick, what is going on?
Allow me to explain, since Master Bottom's plots are always so convoluted. This woman is a soothsayer. And this man hired this woman to get this man's greatest hit. Although I can't believe I'd ever come up with this shit.
Nick, is this true?
I can explain.
You lied to me.
You don't understand.
No, I don't.
Well, this has been fun, Nick. Better luck next time. Oh, tickets on sale now for Richard II. Get them while they're hot. And yeah, that just happened.
They've failed in every way.
I could have warned you that this would happen, but you wouldn't have listened.
No, you did warn me. You told me there would be a great price to pay. And now I have to pay it.
Don't hear her outrage, m'lady, at this vile and offensive production. It was my duty as a magistrate, but more importantly, my duty to God, to have them punished for blasphemy, treason, the employment of a Jew, witchcraft, and the provocative parading of eggs. And for such offenses, the law demands beheading!
Yes! Defendants, do you have a lawyer present?
No, Your Grace.
Production! I am the lawyer, and I say beheading this man would be redundant. Clearly the fool has lost his head already.
Be
more specific. I shall. Did you take the money from the money box?
Yes.
Did you deceive your brother?
Yes.
Did you lie to your wife, who by all means is a wonderful and supportive woman? Write that down.
Yes, I did all of those things.
Which is why I enter a plea of temporary insanity. And before sentencing is pronounced, I think we'd all like to know, what on earth were you thinking?
The learned counselor is right. I lost my mind. No, worse. I lost myself. And it wouldn't have happened if I had just listened. Someone much wiser than me tried to tell me.
For as the day follows the night, sure as the sky turns to blue, this much I know. This much is true. Above all else, in whatever you do, to thine own self be true. Why did I wander so far from the man that the two of you knew I could be? I lost sight of all that mattered somehow. I did not see it then. I see it now.
I just didn't think I had it in me. So I made it harder than it had to be. Should've followed my heart. Should've listened to you. To thine own self be true. To thine own self be true.
That's all very touching, but the law demands beheading, and nothing will change that.
Or can it? The defense calls Master William Shakespeare!
Shakespeare! I'll be seeing you later.
If it pleases the court.
Oh, the court is very pleased. Continue.
Words without thoughts never to heavens go.
I love it when he puts words in the wrong order.
And the quality of mercy is not strained, it droppeth. His gentle rain from heaven.
It's great because he entertains, but he makes you think as well.
However, if a merciful ending is not shown here today, then I shall replay these events on my stage, with these characters and thee at thy bench, and then will I see fair justice done.
Are you saying you want to write a play about this? With me as a character, well, I wouldn't want to look the fool.
Oh, and you shan't, Lady Falstaff. Not if you spare the lives of these mischief makers, and instead see them banished. Send them off this royal throne of kings, this sceptred isle, this blessed plot, this earth, this realm, this England.
I agree. That is much more elegant than beheading. I declare thee banished, shipped on the first trip to the New World, and you can take your so-called musicals with you.
Look! 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 Homosexuals! Come back! Come back! Charge them!
Oh, please! I'm a woman!
Oh, I'm a woman. I'm a woman.
Well, you two are quite welcome.
For what? All of those lines were from my writing. And besides, you're just having us banished so you can get us out of your way.
Aw, poor Nigel.
Beheaded would have been out of my way as well.
No, this world needs you two in it. Just not my world. And besides, this wonderful woman and phenomenal actress persuaded me that I might make a stand for free speech today.
I'd say you got about 20 free speeches in there.
Let it go. All's well that ends well.
Good line.
Stop giving me your best stuff.
Oh, good night, sweet prince. And flights of angels, do something. Exit Shakespeare.
Shakespeare!
Oh, I thought I'd never see you again.
Marcia, what are you doing here? I sent you away.
And I'm going.
But not before I get to say goodbye.
Very well, I will allow it.
It pains the heart to say adieu to someone you love. But alas, the time has come. Goodbye, Father.
What?
Psalm 112. The good man's children shall prosper in the wilderness. You have your poets and I have mine.
What? No! God damn it!
So, you made a deal with Shakespeare.
Well, we wanted a new country home, and now we're getting a home in a new country.
Huh. Didn't see that one coming.
Oh, I hear in the New World, a guy like me can be
anything he wants.
I bet they'll be open to something really original.
And brother, I know just the story we should tell.
Ladies and gentlemen, Shylock Entertainment, in association with Pilgrim Productions, presents The Bottom Brothers and their touching life story.
Who's that coming out of Cornwall with his brother? It's Nick and Nigel Bottom. Who's that starting out with nothing but each other? It's Nick and Nigel Bottom.
Yes, we are the Bottom Brothers, right in place just like our mother said we ought to do. We've learned to take our two.
He almost got Solly headed.
Sorry.
Exactly, just got finished shedding.
Yeah. We came from London on a boat. Here and then we rode away
with songs and dancers galore.
It's something no one else has ever seen before.
So here you go, putting on a show, and not just any old ordinary show.
A big and bold extraordinary show.
A must-see magical, new original musical. A musical. There's nothing as amazing as a musical. You'll see, it will be only beginning this glorious creation called a musical.
Did you hear the news? Shakespeare's new play opened. They say it's his masterpiece.
What's it called?
Hamlet. Hamlet. I was this close.